Sometimes internet issues are really a pain. Now, this video is an easy step-by-step basic troubleshooting. Now, there are more advanced ways to troubleshoot internet connections. So this video may or may not help you, but this is what you want to start to try to do on your own before you have to reach out to someone like your internet provider. Be forewarned. There's a lot of rebooting that's gonna happen here. In this case, let's just assume that none of your computers are working. Every device on your internet, on your network has just got no internet, or in this, you know, white screen, get an error message, blah blah blah. So let's isolate the issue. If it's all devices, go to your modem, router, wireless, whatever you have. Unplug it all and make sure it all powers down. If your modem stays on, it might have a battery and you'll have to pull that too. Once everything is powered down, turn it on. Start with the modem first if you have an external router. Once the modem is all turned on and all the lights stop flashing, then you can turn on your router. If, however, everything's all combined into one unit, don't worry about it. Just plug in your modem, let it boot up. Since it has the wireless router built in, it'll handle everything for you. At least it should. Now, if it's just one computer, restart that. Shut it down. And then turn it back on again. I know in the TV series, The IT Crowd, it's kind of a joke. Have you tried turning it off and on again? But in reality, this is how troubleshooting actually is. Sometimes turning it off and on again really is the fix. Why? Well, computers can crash. Sometimes the network stack just didn't want to work, or your routing table just got corrupted, either on the computer or the modem, or router, I should say. So, I mean, it happens. Sometimes you just got to reboot. Now, let's say you rebooted the computer, and it's still not working. From there, you might need to troubleshoot the computer, and it's going to be beyond the scope of this video, but there's a couple things you can try to see if you can really isolate what's going on. You can open up a command line window on your computer, or a command prompt, if it's Windows, Terminal, if it's Linux, or Mac OS. This is why this is beyond the scope of this video, because every computer can be different. So, you know, depending on your operating system of choice. But some things you can try to do is ping. Ping is a command that basically just, it's like a sonar ping. You're sending out a signal and you're looking to get something back. You can try pinging Google, or you could try pinging a DNS server's IP address, like 8888, I should say 8.8.8.8, or another one like 1.1.1.1. You don't have to use those, but those are easier to remember since they're just the same repetitive number. This will help you figure out if the computer's having an issue connecting to a website because of the name, if it's a DNS issue, or if there's something else going on. So like I said, internet issues can really be complex, but this is all just basically trying to get an idea of what's going on. Now, another thing, is the computer on wireless or Ethernet? If the computer that's not working is on Ethernet, check the cable. Maybe the cable came loose. If it's on Wi-Fi, check to make sure that you're still connected to your wireless network. Maybe you're not. While I wish I could help you more than this, it would take hours to possibly go through every possible troubleshooting method for internet-related issues. So this is just the basics. And by basics, it's mostly power cycling, checking cables, making sure you're connected to your wireless network at all. Beyond that, though, if you have a computer that's under warranty and you're having issues, you can try contacting them, but they may not be able to help you. Contacting your internet service provider, though, really would be the better choice. But do understand, though, if you're using a third-party router with your internet provider, in my case, I'm using one of these. or let's say you have a Linksys Netgear or something, and you bought that router yourself, don't be upset if your internet provider, after testing everything on their end, says that it's not an issue on their side and you have to contact the router manufacturer. I used to work for a cable internet company, and I've had my share of customers that were pretty angry when I told them they had to contact Linksys or Netgear. Trust me, we would rather not have to refer you either, but we're not... The internet provider is only going to be trained on the equipment they provide. So you may have to contact your router manufacturer. It is what it is. Anyway, this video is very simple. It's, like I said, just checking cables, making sure you're connected to Wi-Fi, and just unplugging things and plugging them back in. That's really the basics. Anyway, I hope it helps, though. I know there are a lot of people that don't know even those things, and that's what this video is geared for. Not people with advanced issues. This is geared towards people that may not be aware of this. Novices. And I wouldn't even call them novices. Just regular users. Some people don't know that. Anyway, I hope it helps, though. And if you need any assistance further, like I said, don't be afraid to reach out to your internet provider. They have more tests, and they can help determine if the issue is on their end or if they need to refer you to someone else. Have a good one.
Thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed this content, be sure to click like, subscribe, and if you want notifications, click that bell icon.